In this video, we're going to create a financial model like this for a startup to determine whether it's worth getting started with this business idea. So first, we'll model out our revenue assumptions, considering things like how our customers are going to find us. Then we'll go onto the cost assumptions, looking at things like our ads campaign or our office rent. Then we'll move on to a full income statement to determine how profitable this business idea could be. And finally, we'll create some visuals to support the data. Here's the Excel file we'll be working with, which you can download in the description below. So as you can see, as of now, it's for a total of 12 months, and feel free to extend this out further if you need. So starting with the revenue assumptions, and at the very top is how we're going to get customers. And generally, there's two main ways. One is through organic traffic, and the other one is through paid traffic. So organic is basically maybe you write an article, maybe you have some social media posts, and that's how they discover you organically. Whilst on the other hand, with paid traffic, this is paying for social media ads, Google ads, etc. If we look at some of the assumptions that we've made here for paid traffic, so we have the organic side and we've got the paid side, and the sum of those two is going to be the total traffic. Feel free to adjust these numbers depending on what you think it's gonna do. So I'm just gonna press the shift and then the right arrow, and then I'm gonna press Alt equals. That's gonna sum all of these for me. So if you go and on the first one, press the F2 key, you're gonna see that the sum formula just auto-populated there. From there, obviously not everyone that sees the website is going to buy the product, so there's going to be some kind of a conversion rate. Now intuitively, I'd imagine that organic traffic is going to have a higher conversion as the customer already knows you and they've seen your products or your services, as opposed to paid traffic, where it's kind of forced on and it's a bit more artificial. So if we look over here at our assumptions, you can see that our organic traffic has a 2% conversion, while the paid one has about 1%. Now, depending on what product you sell, that conversion rate is going to vary. So for instance, something very cheap, it's probably gonna have a lot higher a conversion. So let's go ahead and calculate this average conversion just by going to equals average, press the tab key there, once you find the formula, and then we'll select these two, close the brackets and hit enter. And then we're just gonna drag this across like so. Now that we've calculated the total traffic and the conversions, we can go ahead and find the total number of orders. So let's go ahead and type for organic, it's just gonna be equals to the organic percentage multiplied by the total page traffic for organic. The same thing goes for the one below, so I'm just gonna Control C, Control V. From here, let's select both of them, so shift down arrow, then I'm just gonna go shift right and just press the Control R, and that's gonna autofill it for you all the way till the end. From here, for the total orders, just Alt equals, hit enter there, and same thing, shift right arrow and then Control R. Now we know that for the first month, we're expecting to get 40 orders. Now, how much are those orders going to be for? So that's when the order details comes into play. And first, we're gonna have the average item value. So as you can see over here, we assumed a price of $25 for our startup product. And from there, around month seven here, we're gonna go ahead and increase the price, hopefully as the quality of our product improves. Then right below that, we have the number of items per order. So typically when, say, you buy something on Amazon, you might buy more than one product. And so the items per order are going to actually increase. As you can see, first we assume just one, as people are not gonna be that familiar with our product, but as hopefully they start to like it more and more, then they might buy some more of the same thing or some different products that we have up on offering. So from there, the average order value is just gonna be equals to the average item value times the number of items per order. And I'm just gonna drag that across. So shift right arrow and Control R. Awesome, that covers our revenue assumptions. So let's get started with the cost side. So if you scroll down over here, you're gonna find all our cost assumptions. And generally, we're gonna have a big split between fixed costs and variable costs. So the difference here is that the variable ones are going to depend on output. So the more you produce, the higher that cost is going to be, while the fixed ones are going to remain the same. For instance, office rent is going to remain the same regardless of how much you produce. Looking at the numbers over here, you can see that on the variable side, we have manufacturing, order fulfillment, and paid traffic. Let's say that we work with a third party and they're the ones that manufacture it. And as you can see, this is on a per order basis. Now, as you move along towards month seven, you can see that the cost is going to drop. The reason being that hopefully we can negotiate a better deal as we move along and our volume increases. Same thing goes with the fulfillment, so maybe this is the shipping side of things, which we hope will also decrease around there. And lastly, we have the paid traffic. This is on a cost per click basis. So suppose you're paying for Instagram ads, and every time somebody clicks on that ad, then that's when Instagram is going to charge you. That's the variable side. And then on the fixed side, you can see that we have the warehouse rent. Then we've got the office rent, salaries, and other. As you can see, for salaries, we're going to give ourselves a very modest 1,000, and then hopefully in month 7, either we hire a new person and that's why it increases, maybe you want to pay yourself a bit better. And lastly, down over here, we have a standard tax rate of 21%. And again, feel free to modify these assumptions depending on what you think is most suited to your business. And speaking of financial modeling, if you want to learn more about the topic, I recommend checking out Financial Edge, which provides certified online finance courses and is also sponsoring this video. Their best-selling Investment Banker course goes over all the relevant skills to succeed in an analyst role. These include creating a three-statement financial model, the key valuation methods such as a discounted cash flow, and much more. And if you're interested in other areas of finance, they also have courses on private equity, trading, portfolio management, and more. So if you're interested in checking them out, go to the link in the description below where you can get 25% off using code KENJI25. All right, back to the startup. Great, now that we have our cost and our revenue assumptions, we can start working on an income statement to determine whether this business is going to be profitable in the first 12 months. So over here, just scroll down towards where it says income statement. Firstly, we've got the revenue line item, which is simply going to be the price times the quantity. So to us, it's going to be equals to the total orders. So it's going to be right over here, that 40 there, multiplying that by our price, which is going to be our average order value over here, and hit enter. Then the COGS stands for cost of goods sold. And to us, that's going to be our manufacturing cost. So we'll go equals, and we're going to go to manufacturing and multiply that on a per order basis. So multiply by orders, so that's going to be to that 40, and hit enter there. Then the gross profit, simply one minus the other, so equals revenue minus the COGS. Hit enter there, and the gross profit margin, as you can see, the unit is percentage here, simply going to be equals to the gross profit divided by the revenue, and hit enter there. To extend this across, we're just going to select them, so shift down arrow here, and then shift right arrow all the way till the end there, and hit control R. That's going to extend it out for you. As you can see over here, our hope is that the revenues are going to scale quite significantly, especially towards the end, and so will our gross profit margin. Then we need to account for all our other costs. So if you go down arrow over here, you can see that first we have a split by variable costs. So first off, we have the marketing costs here. So this is basically the ad expenditures. And to us, that's going to be equals. Let's go ahead and find the number for our ads per click. So paid traffic, cost per paid click. This is going to be the relevant metric for us. And we'll multiply that by the total traffic. It's paid traffic here. So we'll go and find the paid traffic and just hit enter there. Great. Then we have fulfillment. So equals, that's going to be the order fulfillment here, which is going to be this figure, and multiply that by the total number of orders, so that 40 over here. Hit enter there, and then that's going to be our total variable costs. So we're just going to go alt equals and hit enter. Now just below that we have the contribution margin, which is simply the total revenue minus the variable costs. It does look a bit trickier over here, as we have the cost of goods sold up over here, and this is most likely going to be a variable cost as well, and so we're gonna account for it in there too. So we'll go equals, then firstly we're gonna have the we would basically have the revenue minus the COGS, which is the same thing as a gross profit, minus the total variable costs over here, and hit enter. Then for the contribution margin percentage, it's equals to the contribution margin divided by the revenue for us, and hit enter over there. And again, let's move this across, so Control-Shift up arrow, and then Shift-Right all the way to the end there, and Control-R. Awesome, let's now work on our fixed costs. So go to down arrow over here and you can see that first we have general and administrative. So here we're gonna sum a few different line items. So we'll go equals sum, that's the formula there, hit the tab key. And what we wanna sum, let's go under assumptions. This is general and administrative. So we're gonna sum the warehouse rent, office rent, and salaries into that. Close those brackets and hit enter. And other, we're just gonna put other on its own. So we're just gonna link it equals other like so. Total fixed, alt equals there. That didn't quite work as you can see. So we're just gonna go equals this one plus this one over here, hit enter. And now let's move this across. So shift down arrow, shift right arrow, and control R. If we keep scrolling down over here, you can see that we have a total costs. So equals, that's gonna be our fixed, plus our variable, which is this one here, plus our cost of goods sold as well. Let's not forget that one here. And then just below we have the EBT, which stands for earnings before taxes. So over here, this is simply going to be equals to the contribution margin minus the fixed costs, which we haven't quite accounted for yet, and hit enter there. As you can see, we have a negative number as of now. That's quite common in a startup. So shift down arrow and then shift right again and control R. Great. Now moving on to the taxes. If you recall, we had an assumption for a 21% tax rate, but this really is only going to apply if you have something to be taxed on. So if you have losses like we do in these first 6 months, then there's nothing to be taxed on. So for this, we're going to create a formula of sorts, which says that, hey, if you have a negative figure, then you shouldn't be taxed. So we'll go equals. If this is going to be a conditional statement, press the tab key there. The logical test for us is that the EBT here has to be greater than zero, comma. If that is the case, then we want to multiply the EBT times the tax rate, which is that 21% right over here, comma. Now you can see it says value if false. So if that's not the case, then what should you do? And we're just gonna say in quotations to put an NA sign. We're gonna close those brackets and hit enter. And so naturally when it's negative, it should say NA. Let's move that across so we can see if it's working okay. Control R. And that seems to be about right in that here, it starts to get triggered and it shows the actual number for taxes. Now for the profit or the loss, if we try to do equals the EBT, earnings before taxes, minus the taxes, it's not quite gonna work. That's because this here is a letter. And so we're gonna create another formula here. Press the F2 key to get it inside of there, inside of that tab. And at the very front here where there's the equal sign, we're just gonna go if error, press the tab key. You can see here the instructions if you wanna read them. So I'm gonna press the tab and the value is this one. So this is what we want. But if there is an error, what we want to do is just link it to the EBT, close those brackets and hit enter. This way, as you can see, we had an error here and it's just going to show the profit or the loss. The loss in this case is the same as the EBT. Then shift right arrow again and control R. Great. Now we have a full income statement over here where, as you can see, in the first 6 months, we're actually not going to be making any money. But from there, slowly, we're going to start to scale. And in month 12, we're actually going to be making 5K, which is pretty decent for 1 month. And finally, to visualize these findings, we can create two different charts. If you scroll down over here, they should be auto-populated. And you can see on the one hand, we have the traffic source. So if you remember, there's a split between organic and paid traffic. And the overall trend that we're seeing here is that the organic traffic is going to start to scale quite a bit. And so by the time it's so high, we probably won't need to be paying and investing in paid traffic. So that's why this is gonna slowly start to drop off, which is a positive for us. And then over here, we have the revenues versus the costs. As you can see, the revenues are gonna scale quite similarly to the organic traffic, you could say, while the costs are actually gonna remain pretty much the same or slowly just increase there. The reason for that is that hopefully we're gonna strike better deals with our suppliers and the shipping companies. And so that's what's gonna allow our costs to stay relatively the same. If you wanna learn to make visuals like these, you can check out this video over here where I go over it in more detail, or this other video over here to learn how to do a discounted cash flow on a real company. hit that like and that subscribe button if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.